Master volume automation sounds simple enough, right? But this is actually something I see people doing incorrectly all the time. Typically, people tend to do something like this. You usually want your drop to sound more energetic than the breakdown, and a slight volume reduction during the breakdown can therefore make a huge impact. The problem with this method, though, is that if you have any dynamics processing on the master, you're now automating the volume after the mastering chain. Here's what the waveform will look like if you do this. You can clearly see where the automation is. This is technically not wrong, but you can see that the breakdown is still heavily compressed, and compressed music tends to sound quite fatiguing after a while. Your track will often work much better if you allow the breakdown and the low-energy sections in general to be more dynamic than the main parts. This allows the listeners to catch their breath and relax a bit before the next drop. If you have any mastering plugins or any kind of dynamics processing on the master at all, then it's usually much better to do the following. You can use the scroll wheel on your mouse to move plugins up or down. Add Fruity Balance to the first FX slot on the master. Right-click and make Automation Clip. Then automate the volume like this. The order of the processing is always important. This is the case with volume automation on individual mixer tracks, too. The volume will now be automated before it goes into the compressor, which might not even activate now. Here's what it looks like now. You can clearly see that the breakdown is not only quieter, it's also more dynamic. This makes the drop stand out more, and it will also be perceived as more powerful. And here's what it looks like when automating the fader itself. If you're making a pre-master and you're going to master it later, then it doesn't really matter. Still, this is the way I recommend doing it in most cases. Unless you actually want that compressed sound during low-energy sections. As I've said before, there are really no rules in music. You can pretty much do whatever you want. As long as it sounds good, it's good. If you found this video helpful, then consider subscribing and liking this video. Check out the links below if you need professional feedback on your music, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching!